We're back. Brittany Lynn here, and today we'll be doing Brittany's book review number 13 on The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz. B's podcast, acquire the secrets of success, achieve everything you've always wanted, financial power and influence, satisfying relationships, and a rewarding and enjoyable life. The publisher of this book is Simon & Schwartz in 1959. Pages and time it took me to read. This book was 302 pages. It took me about 10 days to read. Rating, I'm gonna give this book a 4.3 stars. Statement about the author. David Schwartz is a lifelong motivational coach and writer. David dedicated his life to teaching leadership development and life strategy, and it shows. He is a professor, he has his PhD, and he was considered a leading American authority on motivation. His net worth is estimated to be over $1 billion. Great detail of the author's thesis and summary of the main points. This book was a great book on motivation, mindset, habits, and over 4 million copies were sold, so you know it's a great book. The premise of this book is simple. Think big to live big. He claims that success is not so much determined by one's size of their brain, but the size of one's thinking. This book is a great book for entrepreneurship, business, self-improvement, and finance. The Magic of Thinking Big gives you several starting points to develop and strengthen the most important trait for successful people, believing in yourself. No matter whether your life goals are very big and daunting or very small and achievable, chances are you've asked yourself, "Where do I begin?" at least once. The author suggests that you should first start by creating a mindset where you know that you are 100% capable of achieving your goals and dreams. Why does this work? Because once you know you are capable of achieving these things, then it's not so much how, it just kind of happens. You begin to get the creativity and the ideas, the inspiration, and things just fall into place. You start to notice and pick up on the things that will help you achieve your goals, and you are just much more capable once you know you can do it and you believe in yourself. This is why positive psychology is so important. What management and societal leaders are looking for when working with people is the drive to move forward. People are looking for this attitude because that is what makes you persevere in the face of failure and adversity instead of running away at the first roadblock. This book offers many strategies on how you can improve your self-belief and confidence. The first is to constantly work on your creative thinking skills. As opposed to simply just memorizing things and facts, creative thinking will really help you in all situations of your life, so that is much more important. This way your brain can assess and adapt to different situations because it stays flexible. David suggests three things. Always be open to new ideas. Learn something new whenever you can. Ask yourself, how can I do a better job today? Every day. The second strategy is to shut down the negative voices in your head. With the media constantly feeding all this negative news to us and everyone just talking negative all around you, negative thinking is quite the norm. However, you will find that naysayers are often always unsuccessful and unhappy with where they are in their life. Or they're just average. You can help yourself by writing a pep talk to yourself. You can write down all the qualities that are just great that you have, all the accomplishments, things that you're really proud of, like a commercial for yourself. You can look back at or read it to yourself whenever you're feeling down and low. Wine and Wisdom Wednesdays with Brittany Lynn. Chances are you won't become successful on your own. Nobody becomes successful on their own. Even the self-made millionaires and billionaires did not do it alone. They did it with tons of other help and people along the way. This is why you should always work on your network and treat everyone with respect, not just about what you can gain from them, but because these traits will help you become successful. And people are really important to your success. So don't underestimate that. Don't be judgmental towards people. I'd also like to add here real quick that a lot of times online, with all of these controversies and political things, people are going crazy at where the world is headed. People are being divided. People are really picking sides and hating on each other. And it's a lot going on, I'm sure you are well aware, but also be extra careful of bullying others, especially online, and be sure to treat them with respect. It's very easy to be mean to somebody online with a computer screen, especially people are so obsessed with like saving a damsel in distress. They just love to be a bully's bully, and I think this is actually a problem that we all need to work on, because people see one person, they don't like what this person said. People tend to gang up. People love groups, especially groups they're in. It really strokes their ego. This is why people bully others, because it helps them feel better about themselves that it's not them. It's really sad, low-level thinking. And you see all too much of this online with adults because of these diverse opinions. You can still treat each other with respect and be open-minded. Don't bully and gang up on people. Even if you think that person is a bully and now you're trying to save this other person, so you're just going to become evil and stone this other person to death because you're viewing them as a bad person, take a step back and realize that that can also very well probably be a flaw in your perception, and you can't just stone one person to death because you have to treat that person with respect too. You can't just say, except for in these cases, no. Treat everyone with respect. Try to understand them. So especially watch those situations. The author suggests treating everyone like they can make or break your career. Another one says that thinking gives him anxiety, so treat everyone like it's their birthday, even if they don't deserve it. I agree. Just treat everyone with respect, try to understand them. I know it can be hard sometimes, but that should be your goal, to be the bigger person, not to bully somebody who you think is attacking somebody else. That's you trying to be a better person. We're always trying, but that's actually not the route. I'm sure you've heard the saying, you are the average of the five people you hang out with. Well, this is in fact very true. And while you can't change the people you hang out with, you can change the people you hang out with. Be sure to create an environment of high quality people in your circle and life, and only take advice from those who have gone where you want to go. All too often you're going to find people screaming on the rooftops that they give the best advice, for example, in relationships. They know better because they've had 7 divorces. Unfortunately, that only proves that they do not know what they are talking about and that it's not who you should be getting relationship advice from. I'm sorry. Do not seek financial advice from a bum. Jeff Bezos didn't really have many successful friends. I'm sure you know Jeff Bezos from Amazon. So what he did instead was turn to books. I've also done this when I didn't really have all that many successful, high quality people on the same page as me. The people around you can be biographies and books. You'll really get an idea for their mindset and what's going on in their head. You also definitely have to watch your attitude. This can be reflected in the way you walk, talk, and behave. Attitudes are mirrors of the mind, and people always catch on to what's going on. After all, reading body language is how we survived for thousands of years. 2 things you can do to improve your attitude are doing what you think is morally right and always dressing well. I'd like to add on to that as well with the whole doing what you think is morally right. Be very careful with this because unfortunately a lot of very, very dark, sick, evil, satanic agendas prey on naive people doing what they think is morally right. Unfortunately, this is very easy to do. It's kind of like taking candy from a baby by misleading, by just lying and manipulating to make it seem like it's about morals and doing the right thing for the people, when in actuality that is not at all what they are doing and that is not at all what the results will be. It is not for the people. So be very careful and skeptical of what instinct guides you when people are playing with your emotions and heartstrings. Don't be an emotional investor. Dig deeper. Also see Freakonomics for more information on that, kind of in regards to the whole anti-abortion thing. People support women's bodies being owned by the government for some moral cause when that is not the actual cause and agenda. It's really just money, profit, greed. Anyways, no one is born confident, yet everyone can learn. So fake it till you make it. You can control your emotions. You can control your emotions by behaving the way you want to feel. So sit in the first row, make eye contact with people, and walk faster than others. Just like dressing well will make you feel good on the outside, it will in turn do that on the inside as well. There's this old saying, winners find solutions, losers find excuses. This is also very true. Believing in yourself is what makes the difference to where you're going to take responsibility. You're going to view how can I change and how can I improve the situation rather than looking for somebody to blame. Take full responsibility for your life. There are no accidents. Law of attraction. Don't waste energy beating yourself up over what went wrong. Just work on finding the solution and how you can improve for next time. The final argument of this book is that the only difference between successful people and average people is their self-belief and confidence. These qualities cause them to persist long enough to achieve success. The Magic of Thinking Big asserts that creative thinking is the driving force behind success. Think big. Think highly of yourself. Don't underestimate yourself and overestimate other people. I know a lot of people do this in their mind. They always think they're worse and lacking, but others are just better, and that's not true. That's only true because you believe it to be true, so you're creating that truth in your own world and reality. Take your job seriously. Know that the work you do is important. You are who you think you are. Speak up in meetings and discussions. Sit in front. Speak slow, not fast. Do not live in fear. Again, also just watch with all the fear-mongery tactics to get you to act in a certain way. Watch that. That is a tactic. That is business. I believe that is also evil of what that has done, but just be careful because living in fear is like the worst place to live from. That is the opposite of love. It's just a really bad place to live from, so do not live in fear. Do not believe the hype and the fear-mongery and this person tells me that I have to do this or else blah blah blah, all these horrible things are going to happen. Think of their incentive. What do they want you to do and how is that going to work? That's what they're asking. How can I get this person to do that? So they're going to tell them whatever it is you need to hear, whatever is going to work. And unfortunately, a lot of times that is fear, fear tactics, fear mongery, lies, bullshit, agendas. Do not buy into it. Don't live in fear. Walk with good posture. Be enthusiastic. If you are enthusiastic, the people around you will be enthusiastic. Energy rubs off on others. Walk 10 times faster, it shows that you have somewhere to be and you are important. I love to walk fast. It's really fun. I can get so much done in such little time. The only downfall of this is sometimes it gets a little annoying when you are running circles around everyone doing all the work. The way you get others to be enthusiastic is to first be enthusiastic yourself. Be enthusiastic about what you're talking about. An example of this is a professor who's super dull and boring and is totally uninterested in what they're teaching. You also are going to find that subject and content very boring and dull. That will make the class the same way. This is a powerful, practical, and uplifting book to help you get out of a rut, invigorate your goals, and empower you towards success. This book is perfect for you if you feel trapped or stuck at home, at work, in your relationship. If you're constantly a naysayer and you're saying, I can't do that, I shouldn't, I couldn't, blah, 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 read this book. Or if you just need a little confidence boost. This book shows you how to defeat disbelief and the negative power it creates. How to make your mind produce positive thoughts. How to set yourself up for success. How to do more and do it better by turning on your creative power. How to plan a concrete success business program. And how to capitalize on the power of now. You want to cure excusitis. What this is always finding an excuse for everything. Oh, I'm late because this and that. Stop making excuses for your health. Don't talk or worry about it. Be grateful it's as good as it is. Remember, it's better to wear out than it is to rust out. Stop making excuses for your intelligence. Never underestimate your own intelligence. Don't confuse your ability to learn with your ability to think. Remember, attitude is everything. Stickability is 95% of ability. Stop making excuses about your age. Look at it positively and capitalize on its unique advantages. Remember, a 50-year-old is barely 50% into their adult productive life. Do what you want to do. Your best years are still ahead of you. Especially nowadays, we are living so much longer. This is due to sanitary conditions, toilets, clean, hygienic water and not what others may believe mainstream things. Also, be extra careful too with 401(k)s. This is an empty promise of you work until you're 60 and then we will supply you with, you know, your money back for the 20 years. Unfortunately, people are living a lot longer than they think, and market crashes are just stealing people's entire 401k, and then they're just like, whoops, oh well, sorry. Yeah, 401k, I would definitely look into other assets because that's kind of a scam, and it's, people unfortunately are not able to retire these days because they have nothing in their 401k and they have been putting in there their whole lives. It's really sad. Please see Fake for more information on that. Remember, $1 million in your 401k is only going to last you 10 years with $100,000 a year. Can you live off that? Don't be a wishful thinker. Count only on your persistence. Accept the law of cause and effect. The harder you work, the more luck you will have. Destroy fear. And also smash that subscribe button. Isolate your fear. What exactly are you afraid of? Remember, indecision and postponement fertilize fear. And take action. Action cures fear. Don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button. So now we can do some examples of things people might be afraid of and how we can cure that. Fear, some people are embarrassed at their personal appearance. So the action, improve it. Diet, nutrition, working out, these are things you can do. The fear of losing an important customer. The action, you can double down on better service. Even getting a haircut can change someone's perspective on how they look. The fear of failing an exam. Action, instead of sitting there worrying about it, study. The fear of things beyond your control. You can work on things you can control. Work on your faith. Trust the process. Trust yourself. Have faith. And you can also focus on relieving other people's fear. A lot of people learn through helping others, so that's a great way to learn. That's a great way to improve yourself. The fear of what others might think and say. Action, be sure your plan is right, and then execute it. People are always gonna have something to say, and who really cares? You're not gonna be anyone, and you're not gonna be successful if you let that hold you back. People will try to hold you back. People who are unhappy and unsuccessful, they don't like to see others surpass them. That's a really bad attitude, and how this presents is they will try to hold you down. They will try to stop you from getting where you want to go at all costs because they're unhappy with their own selves and life and where they are at, that instead of improving on themselves like they can to get better, they would rather just, some people, unfortunately, their way to feel better about themselves is not by improving themselves, but by tearing others down. If, say, you know, one person's up here in confidence and positive mindset, success, all that, and this person's down here, instead of raising up to be at that same level and to improve themselves, they would rather just try to knock this person down to their level. So be careful of that. The fear of making an investment. What you can do is analyze all the factors and then be decisive. If you have a fear of other people, you can develop your understanding. See beyond the facade to the person underneath. And remember, people are much more alike than they are different. Unlock ambition. Destroy the weapons that murder desire and ambition. Self-depreciation. Eliminate excuses and build confidence until you realize you can do it. Security-itis. Don't let security destroy success. Don't mistake security for success. Don't let comfort murder your dreams. A comfortable job doesn't mean that's where you want to end up for the rest of your life. Don't be so afraid to leave the comfort zone because of the fear of the unknown. Health, wealth, and happiness. If it makes you happy, follow it. Competition. Competition thins out quickly above the ground floor. Think big to get above it. Parental dictation. Your parents want you to be successful. Don't let the limitations of their experience hold you back. Family responsibility. You owe it to your family to be the best person you can be. Use it as inspiration, not as an excuse. Don't let little people drive you down. If your family doesn't inspire you, be the one to inspire your family. If your family inspires you, be inspired by them. If you think big enough, you will always be immune to the attacks of petty people. To help, expect it. expect to be sniped at. Again, that is a part of the process of evolving and reaching higher levels of success and who you want to be. That's just a natural part of the effect. If you let them win, they will be happy to have more average Joes aside of them, and you will be unhappy. Do not let them win. It's proof that you are growing. Refuse to fight petty people. Doing so only reduces yourself to their size. And remember that snipers are psychologically sick. Be big. Feel sorry for them. How to make your mind produce positive thoughts. Build confidence. Dwell on thoughts of positivity and gratitude, and deposit only positive thoughts in your memory. Reframe negative memories in a positive light. Refuse to dwell on or withdraw negative memories from your memory bank. Take action. To think confidently, act confidently. Sit up straight. Practice speaking up and smile big. Show those teeth. Make your attitudes your allies. Grow the attitude of I'm activated, enthusiasm, and confidence. Enthusiasm is contagious. To develop it for things and people. Dig deeper. We become more enthusiastic about things we know more about. Add energy. Add energy to your life, your daily routines, the day-to-day mundane stuff. Be excited about it. Be happy about it. Be thankful that you get to drive your kids to school because you have kids you love. Add life to your actions, smiles, talk, and all that you do in your life will be your reward. Be the good news. Spread only good news about people, events, things. Spread only good news about your experience and feelings, and you will become and feel like good news. Grow the attitude of you are important. Value people and see them as important. Everyone wants to be viewed this way, and everyone is important. Practice appreciation. Go out of your way to give honest, true compliments to people. Give them personalized comments on their appearance, their work, their attitude, ideas, and loyal efforts. Call people by their names. No sound is as sweet to someone as their name. Take pains to pronounce and spell it correctly. Invest the credit in others. Make sure to give credit where credit is due, or people will not continue to work with you. I have many people that I will not work with for this reason, because my time is valuable, I'm valuable, and if you're not going to give me credit for what I bring to the table, you are not going to have me at your table. Give others planned attention. Put others first and be thoughtful about being thoughtful. Grow the attitude of service first and let money take care of itself. If you focus on the customer and giving them what they really need and what could really benefit them and how you can truly bring value to people, the money will follow. Always give more to others than they expect to get. Believe you can succeed and you will. Think I will succeed. Think I can, not I can't. Think I'm equal to the best, not I'm outclassed. Give yourself a pep talk several times a day. Ask yourself, what are my best qualities? And don't be shy. That's right, I'm telling you to talk to yourself. Cheers. Write them down. Remind yourself when you're feeling down and low. I've seriously done these things and they truly help. Also, affirmations, incantations. We all need these reminders every now and then. We all have our ups and downs. Don't forget how awesome you are. Make an inspirational commercial to yourself. Write it down. Know it. Recite your commercial to yourself silently several times a day. And believe in the process. Success comes from well-managed thinking. Remind yourself regularly that you are better than you think you are. Successful people aren't Superman, they just believe in themselves. Anyone who is now good at something was once bad. Believe big. Big ideas and plans are often easier than small ones. People just don't think that that's the case. Remember, the size of your success is determined by the size of your belief. How to set yourself up for success? Think right towards people. Your success does depend on other people, so to get their support willingly, be a likable person. Being likable starts with thinking right towards people. Take the initiative in building relationships. Be active and introduce yourself. Be sure you get their name straight. Be sure you can pronounce it as they do. Write difficult names down and be sure you spell them correctly. You don't want to be calling them Jeffrey if their name's Jeffrey, or Ramon if their name is Reuben. Drop a personal note to or call friends that you would like to know better. And say nice things to strangers. Sometimes you really don't know the impact that can have on someone, what kind of day or what somebody is going through, so it's always great to be nice to strangers. We don't need any more school incidents. Be interested in and like other people. if necessary, practice liking until actual liking sets in.
Like relationships.
Ask questions. Listen and learn with genuine interest. Dwell on the positive thoughts you have of others, and never miss a chance to congratulate or empathize. Be interesting and give value to others, but guard against being a know-it-all. Smooth the scratchy parts of your personality. Be a pleasure to be around. For example, I know some people who take such pride that they are so honest and open and no filter, and they're actually really just mean and disrespectful and rude and uncalled for, and people just don't really like that. I mean, you can be honest, but do it with class and tact. Don't just think, oh, well, I'm their mom, so I can treat them like the scum of the earth because I'm being honest and I mean well. That doesn't matter. Eventually, they're just gonna wise up and they're not gonna take your drama and crap and negativity that you are bringing to their life. Remember, we are the people we associate with, so if that's how you're bringing, people aren't going to want to be around that. That's why kids do drugs or run away. Quickly and earnestly find ways to heal any misunderstandings or to avoid them. Accept human differences and limitations. Accept others without trying to reform them. And learn to disagree without being disagreeable. Be an adult. Treat others with respect. You can disagree. You can have a conversation. You can debate. But don't forget, you're still an adult. Still have class and maturity and respect. I am seeing way too many children on the playground after school on Facebook. Be generous with your time, energy, and strength. Encourage others to talk. Practice courtesy all the time. And don't blame others when you have a setback. Do all these things and never try to buy a friendship. It's not for sale. Of course, you can buy what appears to be a friendship and you could buy people in your life, but that is not an actual valid friendship. So be sure to know the difference. If you're just buying company and buying people to hang around, you can definitely do that, and money can definitely buy you that trophy wife, but does she actually love you? I don't know. Probably not if you bought her. Dress right, you cannot afford not to. You become what you and those around you judge you to be. We and others judge ourselves overwhelmingly by appearance, so take good care to be happy with yours, to be the person that you want to become. To make dressing right affordable, pick quality over quantity. These things will typically last a lot longer and will look nicer. Manage your environment to recondition yourself for success. I love feng shui. We're working on a lot of fall cleaning and removing clutter because a small little house that gets cluttered easily has a huge effect on your success. Manage your mentors. Get your advice from successful people. And don't take advice from someone you wouldn't trade places with, or at least in regard to what they're giving advice about. Again, I'm not going to get financial advice from someone who is not doing very well financially and I'm doing better. Sorry, this is just the way it goes. My mentors are millionaires and billionaires. That's why I like to add what they've done and their net worth, because this is who I learn from, because this is what I want to be. Manage your peers. Circulate in new groups and energize yourself and find new ways of thinking. Select friends who have different views from yourself. This can also be great in work settings because you're around a lot of people that you might not normally be around. You might be hanging out with people who are from totally different walks of life and phases. You could really learn a lot and open your perspective, gain more references, and just really become a more evolved, better person. I know it's not always easy, but it can definitely be beneficial. Surround yourself with big thinkers and doers. Don't let small thinking people hold you back. They will try ruthlessly. Do not let them. Manage your energy. Don't gossip, condemn, or take part in negative conversations. Again, this is very common. You know, you'll be somewhere and everyone's watching a fight and it's really bad energy and they're all like, oh, crowding around, come on, Brittany. Like, I don't want to be a part of that and I'm going to walk the other way because it's bringing negative energy to me, just like a lot of people who share dogs getting beat on Facebook. A lot of times people unfriend those people because they don't want to see that because they are guarding and protecting their energy, and that's just really bringing them down. Taking an axe and chopping your neighbor's furniture to pieces won't make your furniture look any better. Think big. How to do more and do it better by turning on your creative power. Think big. Use words that promise victory, hope, happiness, and pleasure. Use big, positive, cheerful words and phrases to describe how you feel. Use bright, cheerful, positive words and phrases to describe other people. Use positive language to encourage others. And use positive words to outline plans for others. Stretch your vision always to see what can be and not what is. For example, if you're selling a property, it might just be a piece of land, but visualize what it can be when trying to sell it. Because that's really true. That's your creative energy. What can you put here? What's this a good market for? What would work well here? Be creative, not just this is just a plot of land. No, you could build a shop, have a yacht, car remote, build sandcastles, you could dump a bunch of sand, play sand volleyball, build a house. Practice adding value to things, people, and yourself. Things. What can I do to add value to this room, house, building, or business? People. What can I do to bring out the best in this person? Yourself. What can I do to make myself more valuable today? Think and talk big. Ask, is it really important enough to get worked up about? Or is the way I'm thinking about this the way an important person would think about this? Think about trivial things and focus on getting the big points across. Stay focused on the big objectives. Don't win battles at the expense of the war. And remember, you never gain anything from an argument, but you always lose something. Think and dream creatively. Become receptive to and welcome new ideas. Eliminate the words impossible, won't work, can't do, no use in trying from your vocabulary. Be an experimental person that constantly breaks up fixed routines and tries new things. Learn to become interested in things beyond your job. Devote 10 minutes each day to asking, how can I do better? How can I do better today? How can I be a better friend, parent, or partner? How can I do a better job? What can I do to encourage my employees? And what special favor can I do for my customers? Ask yourself daily, how can I do more? Ask, how can I increase my personal efficiency? Always look for and take intelligent shortcuts. Work smarter, not harder. Watch busy work. Also, if you can pay someone to do a tedious task like mowing the lawn, do it. And free up some time for yourself, then do it. Buy yourself time. That's just like, I'm gonna get a property manager with all my rental properties so I don't have to do it. That way I can focus on buying more properties and working on my strengths in other areas. I'm not all that concerned about the 8 to 10%. Remember, capacity is a state of mind. Practice asking and listening to others. Join and meet regularly with a stimulating group in your occupational area, an inspiring group outside of your normal occupational or social area. Encourage others to talk. Test your own views in the form of questions. And concentrate on trade minds with people you want to influence. Inhabit their perspective. Ask how you would react if treated the same way. Think, what is the humane way to handle this? Explain, sacrifice, empathize, respect. Inspire and let your actions show that you put people first. Think progress, believe in progress, push for progress. Think, act, live, and believe in improvement and high standards at work, at home, in your community, and with yourself. Take time out to confer with yourself and tap your supreme thinking power. Make quiet, focused time every day just to sit in solitude and think. Confer with yourself. Also, you can journal, meditate, you can do this during that time. How to plan a concrete success building program. Use goals to help you grow. Set a clear vision of where you want to be 10 years from now. Visualize your home, work, and social community lives separately. Write your 10-year plan. Ask, what do I want to accomplish? Who do I want to be? Who will satisfy me? And how will I get there? Set goals that excite and inspire you. Desire, when harnessed, is what powers the heart and soul effort that success demands. Pick one major goal at a time and let it absorb you. Allow your subconscious to go to work for you. Chip away at the goal step by step. See even the smallest of actions as steps either toward or away from your goal. For example, I could record a video or I can go out with my friends. One of them is going to bring me closer to my goal, one of them is going to bring me farther. Build 30-day self-improvement goals and work on them daily. Look for bad habits to break, ways to sharpen your mind, and opportunities to be better at work and at home. Expect an experiment with unexpected and interesting detours. But don't let a change of route keep you from moving towards your goals. Invest in yourself. Invest in things that build mental power and efficiency. And invest especially in education or idea starters. Turn defeat into victory. Every journey has its trials and setbacks. The key to success is how you handle them. Study your setbacks. When you lose, find the root cause of your defeat and learn from it. Be constructively self-critical and seek honest feedback. Identify your weaknesses and then go to work on them. Stop blaming luck. Take responsibility. You are in charge of your own luck. Capitalize on every opportunity to grow bigger, stronger, and more self-resilient. Blend persistence with experimentation. There is a way. You may just need to step back and experiment to find it. Find the good in every situation, and remember, there is no such thing as failure, only feedback. How to capitalize on the power of now. Get the action habit. Be a doer, not a don'ter. Take action every day to move forward. Don't wait for perfect conditions. Expect future obstacles and solve them as they arise. Remember, ideas alone will not bring success. Wisdom without industry leads to triviality. Use action to cure fear and gain confidence. Do the thing you fear, and the death of fear is certain. Start mechanically. Act even if you don't feel like it. You'll soon warm up to the task. Think in terms of now, not tomorrow, not next week, not next year. Start right now. Now means now. Don't waste time procrastinating. Act. Seize the initiative. Be a self-starter. Be the starting gun. Show the ability and the ambition to do it. The magic of thinking big is a powerful reminder that we are capable of exactly what we think we are capable of. And while it's clearly untrue that nothing is impossible, the limits of who we might be and what we might do lie far, far beyond the dip of our current horizon. So defeat disbelief, cultivate positivity, set yourself up for success, decide who you want to be, clarify what you want, and get to work making it real. Be big, believe big, take big action, and above all, do it now. Because the only person responsible for your thinking is you. Evaluations of the strengths and the weaknesses. This book was filled with strengths. I personally love how it focuses so much on believing in yourself. Honestly, that is just such a great quality to have if you want to be successful. Sometimes people will try to hold others back. Believing in yourself is so critical to any success in life. Sometimes this can also be seen as cocky, egotistical. Again, some people do not like to see people successful and happy. There is a difference between cocky and egotistical and all of that. But sometimes it can be confused. I think as long as you're a good person and you respect others and don't be afraid to believe in and love yourself, don't let those naysayers hold you back. You need to love yourself or nobody else will. Weaknesses, I was trying to think of one, but I couldn't. Sorry. Also, just be careful as well, focusing on all your weaknesses. Don't forget your strengths while doing this. Don't focus on them so much that you see yourself as only having weaknesses and things to work on, because that's definitely not the case. Just be sure to get a clear picture. Contribution or bias. I definitely agree with believing in yourself as being like the most important thing to become successful. I've definitely had to overcome this in my own life. You have to believe in yourself or no one else will. You will not get anything you do not believe you are deserving of. You can work and study and grind and put in so much effort, but if you don't actually truly believe that you are worthy and deserving of that raise or that car or whatever it may be, that relationship, then you won't get it. Evidence, people will treat you differently depending on how you treat and value yourself. This can be seen everywhere, all around. It's proven that we all have a sixth sense, and so people can pick up on these things. We've survived thousands of years by reading body language. If you judge yourself and you have a problem with your own self, you may feel that others are judging you. And unfortunately, you're probably gonna be right. This doesn't mean they don't like you or that they would judge you otherwise. They're probably honestly just picking up on this person doesn't like themselves. They have a confidence issue. Why? What is it that they don't like about themselves? What are they hiding? Then they become curious and they may feel the same way, but that's not their feeling, so you can't blame it on them. This is why you have to take responsibility for your life. Look in the mirror and maybe realize that they're just reading that off of you, and change it. Change yourself from the inside out and others will view you differently. This also works for the other way, like loving yourself as well, of course. You won't get the love you want until you are worthy and you know that you are deserving of it. You can go through multiple people and find yourself in the same situation and you can blame it all on them. But again, winners will take a look in the mirror, take responsibility, change from the inside out, and break the pattern. Final assessment, I love this book. I wish this was one of those books that they made us read as a mandatory reading in school, but obviously they're not gonna teach you what you really need to know in school. Any recommendations? Share this with your friends. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you guys thought. Follow my YouTubes for all the things that they missed in school. The vital skills for life that you will need to be successful and happy, they're right here. I do tons of book reviews on very similar topics like mindset, habit, things of that nature. So be sure to look out for those that I've done and for more coming in the future. All right, thank you guys so much. Get wrecked. Okay. Sweet.
Oh, I was never recording.
Ha ha ha.